number of registrations that we have seen, which has crossed, you know, it's been close to 200 registrations, although at the moment I see about 88 odd people who have joined in. So I expect more people to join in during the day. So that's it. So we will not be charging. It will be free of charge for all our members. So I hope to attract a maximum participation for the event. And obviously, if any of the members can arrange sponsorship, please do contact me. So thank you all for your patient listening and best wishes for today's session. With that, I would have hand back the control to CA Clifford. Thank you.
Thank you, CA Ajay. So we have with us today a technical expert, Mr. Nagarajan, a bachelor in engineering, computer science. He's IT by profession with 11 years of experience and 5 years and above experience in his financial market. He is doing a freelancer in stock market investors training portfolio advisor. He has his own group of Telegram channel and WhatsApp. And he has recommended in various segments of stocks, commodity, currency, and cryptocurrencies. So he has also doing the training batches for technical things for the new and freshers to learn about the technical analysis. Till now, he has completed 13 batches so far. He has his own YouTube channel. So with this, I welcome Mr. Nagarajan for the topic, The Power of Candlesticks and Magic of Fibonacci. Over to you.
First of all, thanks to Mr. Ajay, CA Ajay Kumar and CA Clifford D'Souza for giving me a wonderful opportunity for presenting this session to elite audience of CA Bahrain chapter. Good evening, one and all. So before getting into our session, I would like to speak few things about these candlestick patterns and other stuffs about technical analysis. So today we are going to see what is candlestick patterns and Fibonacci. Before that, everybody knows these kind of candlesticks in YouTube videos or books, everything, everywhere we can see these kind of candlesticks. But why or the way we are going to consume the depth of the candlesticks will make us a better analyst. So that is what we are going to see. And market is all about mass psychology. When intuition of mass people believe that a stock, particular stock or an index is going to be a buy, then obviously it is going to be a buy. That is what we can interpret with the help of candlesticks, and that is what we are going to learn about in today's session. And as you guys are very good in fundamental analysis, you should be knowing this fact, market is all about probability and statistics. So that is where the patterns and probability of winning will be more. So those steps will be seen, and the patterns which I'm going to explain is like very, very back-tested and perfect patterns. I believe Clifford D'Souza has been part of my Telegram channel and WhatsApp group for quite 1.5 years, close to 2 years, I believe, and he would have seen the accuracy. So we'll see one by one. And these are my personal setups, which I have been back-testing for years with certain softwares and personal backtesting in each and every time frame, starting from 1 minute candles to 1 month candle, and slowly we'll get into it. And what we can conclude with the candlesticks is who is going to win the game, whether the buyer is going to win the game or the seller. So knowing this pattern and sticking with certain rules will make this pattern more reliable and robust. So if you ask me to explain these patterns for 4 hours, I can do that, because this pattern is having so much of learning, so much of meaning behind the candle, each and every candle. If you want to look at the end of EOD, that is the end of the day chart, and finding these patterns will be pretty easy. But to capture the movement in the live market is the real challenge. So that is what I'm going to explain in a very simple manner. And that I do for my group members on a regular basis. I post live charts whenever I see these patterns obeying my rules. And there are only two things in the market. One is a trend continuation. The other is going to be trend reversal. So in the market, all we need is entries at the right time to make a good profit and cut with minimum losses. So for that, definitely we should need certain setups, certain rules, which should be learned properly. So the powerful candlesticks, the candlesticks which I'm going to show, or each and every candlesticks are going to be trend reversal candlesticks. So which will give you exact signals for entries and very good caution for proper exit. So I believe, I strongly believe everyone would have learned ABCD in the childhood, and now we are not learning on in it on a daily basis. Once we learned the ABCD and we started reading or writing alphabets again and again, we are not doing the same thing. We are not learning, going back to ABCD and learning it daily. Same way, once we start learning these candlestick, is this a one-time learning and rest of the life earning? So similarly, I'll say, like, before getting into the topic, which many have, even when Ajay joined my session, one sample session, he asked why the Fibonacci is occurring occurring every time and it is respecting the exact numbers. And I gave the answer, but I don't know whether he's remembering it or not. But I will say, like, there is a very famous trader by the name Jesse Livermore. He was trading in the early 19th century. He earned $100 million in just trading, in day trading. He is not an investor, he is a day trader. And he researched the human behavior for 4,000 to 5,000 years and found this fact: what has happened in the past will happen again. And many you would have seen this line, like, history repeats itself. This is what the exact line he quoted in his books. What has happened in the past will happen again. And this is because markets are driven by humans and human never changes. This is what his lines are. And that is why the patterns repeat again and again. So that is what I'm going to show you in the live charts. So let us get begin with the session. Please let me know once you are able to see my screen. So these are the four main topics we are going to discuss about today. So what are the types of trend, support and resistance, candlesticks and Fibonacci? So I have mentioned, like, the topic is all about the power of powerful candlesticks and Fibonacci, the magical number of Fibonacci. But I have included two more things: types of trend and support and resistance, because without knowing types of trend and support and resistance, we cannot understand the real meaning of candlesticks setups. So I'll try to give my best in a very short manner and we'll proceed with the candlestick setups. So okay, these are going to be the different types of trends. We have three types of trends. One is uptrend, one is downtrend, and the other trend is sideways, or we can call it as range-bound market. So in the year, in a one single year, that is 365 days, we have almost 60% of the days the market will be in sideways. Trading in the sideways is an art. So we can learn that with the help of this candlesticks itself. So let's begin. So what normally when we see a trend or a stock, we can have, when it is moving upside, we cannot say it is an uptrend. It should follow a proper trend like this. It should have a structure like this. It should start from a low value. It should go and reach a high value, and then it has to come to a higher low, and then it has to go to the higher high. This is what a structure of an uptrend. When a stock is respecting this structure, then the stock is said to be in uptrend. Same way, the stock should start at the high place, then it should come to the low value, then again it should retrace, making a lower high, and then it should give a breakout below this level, this lower level, and it should come and make a lower low. Then only the trend of the stock is said to be downtrend. And the same way, the sideways or the range of market should be in this pattern. So it should start in the value in a particular range, from a low value, then it should go to a certain price, and it has to come to a certain same level, or maybe a 0.5 or 0.25 difference can be there. So again, it can continue for years, if you take Reliance chart and see, the Reliance just gave breakout in this year. Almost for past 10 years, the Reliance was trading in the 500 to 900 range. And once it has gave a breakout above 900, and I believe we can see what is happening in the market right now. It is going in the, it has boomed, it is getting boomed just like that. So these are the types of trend which we should know. And we'll get back to what is support and resistance. So let us say here, the stock is here. We are, this is the current price of the current price of the stock. And when, let us begin from here. If the stock has started trending and it is going to a certain level, let's say the stock started from 50 rupees and it reaches to 100 rupees. What happens here? There is some kind of resistance, or there may be some type of supply. Maybe the trader who started buying here at 50 rupees might have thought like, okay, I have got some 100% profit, so let me book it. So that is where, when the same intuition happens with millions of traders, that is where the supply begins. And that place is going to be called as resistance. And obviously, it comes down to a certain place. In this point of time, a new trader may come into the market. Only at that time, certain list of people come into the market and seeing this place, which is, let's say this is going to be 75 rupees. Okay, for that trader, this price is going to be a low price. So he starts buying, and same intuition for millions of traders may happen. And when they start buying this stock at this place, so that is where the support comes into picture. So again, it can go to the same place where the previous resistance comes into picture, and again, it can come down. And this is where the resistance, that is the supply, where the supply gets started and the price drops, is the place is called resistance. And again, once the resistance is broken, it will go to the next level of resistance. Say, for example, if the 100 rupees is broken, it can go to the next level, let's say 200, and it can come to the place again and take a support at this place, because previously this place was behaving as a resistance and now it has gone up, breaking this level, and it can act as a support. That is what I have mentioned here. And again, it can be in a range starting from this support area to this is resistance area. So the main aim of understanding the support and resistance is where the buyers are ready to support the stock and buy, so that is where the demand gets created and the price of the stock increases. And obviously, when this mass psychology of people starts booking their profit, or there may be some fundamental news, the company would have announced some bad results, or the company management would have got some issues, anything may happen. But the mass psychology of people then believes this price is going to be high, that is where the supply starts. So that place is called, obviously, the supply or resistance. So this is a very basic idea about supply and demand. So support and resistance. Let's get into our candlesticks chapters. Okay. We have many more patterns. We have more than 80 plus candlesticks. So are we going to learn all the 80 plus candlesticks? I have listed almost some 60 plus here, because space is not here enough. So that is why I have just limited to 60 plus. So we are not going to learn all the 60 plus candlesticks in this session. I'm going to teach you just six patterns, very, very strong pattern, strong trend reversal patterns, which have dominated the market for almost 30, 40 years. I'm going to show you the charts for past 30, 40 years, and you'll understand how strongly or how dominant these candlestick patterns have acted and given some profits to the traders who have understood the patterns. So let's begin with the, this is going to be a very basic candlestick. So this green candle, we call it as a bullish candle, and the red candle is going to be a bearish candle. So why, if we can change the color of the candles, we can change it to blue, black, white, anything, but it is a universal color code. When a stock, let's say the stock in a particular time frame or in a particular day, if a stock has started or opened at a particular place, let's say 100, and it came down till 98 and it went up all the way, and it made a high of 112 and it closed at 110. So the meaning is when the price of the stock in a particular day or in a particular time closed above the open price is going to be bullish. And in the same way, when the stock is has opened in a high price and went to even higher and came all the way down and closed below the opening price, that is where the candle ends with a bullish signal. That is a bearish signal. So that day, that particular day, we will be getting a red candle. So that is called a bearish candle. So this is a very basic idea how to read a candlestick. So anyways, I'll be sharing this document to whoever attended the session. So you can just go through this and get a basic idea of how to read a candlestick. I strongly believe you people are brilliant fundamental analysts. So you should be knowing all these stuff. But as part of my, from my part, I have just put a picture with a clear explanation. So let's begin with the six patterns. So first pattern is going to be Doji. Doji is a very, very important trend reversal pattern. This trend reversal pattern is a indecisive pattern. And this is where, when this pattern occurs, obviously the trend of the market will be changed. 99% it will be changed. If it is occurring in an uptrend, the trend of the trend of the stock or index can change to down, or it can give a correction or a retracement. That is where doji comes into the picture. So we have three types of doji. We have fighter sub doji, but these three dojis are very, very important. So I have just made given these three patterns, and I'll explain one by one. So when this kind of long leg doji, so it has a very small body. It the stock opened at 100 rupees and it went down to 90 rupees and it went to 110, but it closed at the same place, maybe 100.10 or 100.20 or 99.9 it can be, but almost the same place where it started and it closed in the same place. That is where this kind of long leg doji happens, comes into picture. So meaning, so the psychology behind this long leg doji is the buyer and seller has made a tug of war competition and nobody won. It is like a draw match. That is where this long leg doji comes into picture. And this doji is a dragonfly doji. Dragonfly doji comes when the buyers are in control. That is where this doji comes into picture. The open price, this is, let's say the stock got opened at 100 rupees and it went all the way to 80, and the buyers came into control and they started buying in huge quantity and they closed on the same particular day at the same price or maybe the high price, like let's say 150 or 101. But it didn't give the control to the sellers. The buyers took control from this place to such a high place and they got closed in a high price. That is where this dragonfly doji comes into picture. So gravestone doji, the name itself shows what does the gravestone have, what does the meaning of gravestone. Obviously, the price has been beaten like anything by the sellers, and sellers has dominated. Let's say the price got opened at 100 rupees. Buyers tried their best to make it take it to a higher price, but they lost the game to the sellers. And sellers took the control and they closed the day at low. That is where this kind of gravestone doji comes into picture. So candles and all is fine. So when and where to apply this candles, or when to validate this candle, that is what is very special about this session. So I have set up some rules which I have been following and I have been backtested. So I'll be showing the live chat as well. So we have three different rules, when and where to validate these candlestick patterns. Let's go to the rules. Rule number one, if it is formed in the bottom of the downtrend or formed at the top of the uptrend, wait for a confirmation and buy or sell. If it is formed in the downtrend, we can go for a buy. If it is formed in the uptrend, you can go for a sell after a confirmation. So this is why I explained about support area and resistance area. What is support? What is resistance? So if it is formed in the support area, because these are trend reversal candles, when these candles formed in the support area, obviously then go for a buy if it is formed in the support area. So if it is formed in the resistance area, obviously we can go for a sell. There are techniques to measure the stop loss. There are two kind of stop loss techniques, which is demand supply zone stop loss, and one more is wick measurement stop loss. That is how we have to measure the wick, and we have to set up the stop loss, and obviously we will not be lost in this technique with this when we follow this rule. And we should not validate when we are in the sideways market. These candlesticks are not applicable when we are in the sideways market. Irrespective of time frame, we should not validate this in the sideways market. So the next pattern, first pattern we saw doji, long leg doji, butterfly, dragonfly doji, and the third one is gray zone doji. And the next pattern is going to be spinning tops. This spinning top is also very important topic and very important pattern. And color of, first of all, I have given a note, the color of the doji doesn't matter, because we have two kind of dojis. One is bullish spinning top. Sorry, these are two kind of spinning tops. One is bullish spinning top and one is bearing spinning top. Difference between this doji, long leg doji, and the spinning top is very simple. There will be no body in the doji, but in the spinning top, there will be a very, very small body. The opening price and the close price, there will be a difference. Say, let's say the price opened of in a particular stock, the price opened at 100 rupees and it went all the way down to 95 and it went up till 110 and it closed at 102. There should be a difference in the open and close price. That is where this kind of spinning top will come into picture. And same way, on any particular day, the stock can open at 100 and it can go up to 110 and it can go down to 90 and it got closed at 98. That is, there should be a two rupees difference. That is where the bearish spinning top comes into picture. And color of the candle doesn't matter. It is a spinning tops are very indecisive candle. Doji, long leg doji, and spinning tops are indecisive candles. So the sentiment in the market is indecisive. The buyers are not in the mood to make the price higher, or they are not ready to offer more than this, and sellers are not ready to give up. That is where this kind of candles come into picture. So same rules goes for this. If it is formed in the uptrend, we can wait for a confirmation and we can go for a sell. And when it is formed in the downtrend, we can wait for a confirmation and buy. If this is forming in the support area, obviously we can directly go for a buy. And if it is forming in the sideways, no need to validate the pattern. And the third pattern is hammer and hanging man. What happens when somebody is hitting some object with a handle? Obviously that object will rise up or it will jump. That is what happens with hammer. When a hammer pattern comes into picture, obviously the trend of the market is bullish. When the pat, this kind of how to validate this hammer, the body and the tail, we call it as wick technically. So the wick should be 2.5 times greater than the body. That is how we have to validate a hammer and hanging man. When the color of the candle is green, we call it as a hammer. And when the color of the candle is red, we call it as a hanging man. And when it is going to be green color, it is a hammer. And hammer is a bullish symbol and hanging man is a bearish symbol. So how to trade this candle? Same rules. When it is formed in the downtrend, wait for a confirmation. That is another day of bullishness, then we can go for a buy at this place. When this candle is forming in the support area, obviously we can directly go for a buy. We should be in profits. And this candle, how we have to trade? So same way, if it is forming in the uptrend, we have to wait for a confirmation. That is next day of selling, and then we can go for a sell. If you are an investor, we can take an exit. If it is forming in the monthly candle, obviously we can go for an exit. if you are a trader, you can trade, take a sell, and you can take profits. So, and if it is forming in the sideways, no need to validate these candles. And the fifth pattern. So far, we have seen three patterns. The fourth pattern is inverted hammer and shooting star. This hammer, same way we have to validate, the wick should be 2.5 times greater than the body. And if just like it looks like a hammer is turned upside down. So that is where this kind of candle comes into picture, and same rules. And same here, only the difference is color. Inverted hammer is a bullish and shooting star is a bearish. We can call it the shooting star as a rejection candle itself also. Rejection candle, how we can say rejection candle? Let's say the price of the price on a particular day or in a particular time frame, it has started at 100 rupees. It went all the way to 120 and the price got rejected by the buyers. And sellers took in control and they rejected, and the day got closed at this place, lesser than 100, let's say 95. That is where this kind of shooting star comes. In sky, when we see a shooting star, obviously what will happen in next 2-3 days, it will fall down. So that is also same case applies goes for here as well. It's a shooting star will come down. The price of the stock will come down. So same rules, when it is formed in the downtrend, we can wait for a confirmation, that is the next bullish day, and we can go for a buy. And if it is formed in the support area, we can directly go for a buy. If it is formed in the sideways, no need to validate. And same rules for this. If it is formed in the uptrend, wait for a confirmation and sell. That is next day of selling, then we can exit. If you are an investor, if you are a trader, you can just take an exit if it is forming in the monthly candle. Then don't validate both the candles in sideways market. Sideways market happens because of there will be no smart players or smart money or professionals. They doesn't participate, or that is where a sideways market come into picture. The consolidation will happen for months, years, maybe a decade also that happens. So don't validate these patterns in sideways market. And so far we have seen all the candles are single candle patterns, and this candle is going to be dual candle pattern, and this is called bullish engulfing, meaning this red candle is engulfed by the green candle. That is where this engulfing pattern will come. And this is called bearish engulfing, meaning a bearish candle has engulfed the bullish candle. That is where this kind of pattern will come. And there are multiple candles. If you go to Google and search for bullish engulfing, there may be a lot of different patterns. And this is a valid, and this is going to be a very robust pattern. If there might be like, if you go to Google and search for bullish engulfing, a small red candle would have been there, and the next green candle will be there. There might be gap downs or gap ups. I'll show you in the real time chart, but no need to validate those kind of patterns. Please follow this pattern, which has very high accuracy, meaning the next day, for example, this candle started at 100 rupees and closed at 90 rupees. If the next day, if the candle starts at here, maybe 95 rupees, don't validate that kind of candle. If there is a gap up, don't validate it. The bullish engulfing should happen only where the previous day got closed, or the bearish engulfing should be validated where the previous day got closed. The same area, the next candle, the bearish candle should open, and it has to come down and close below this level. And the validation for this is a key point. We can say like this candle, this bullish candle should be 150% more than this candle. If this candle is considered 100%, it should be 50% more than this candle. Then only this is called perfect bullish engulfing pattern. And same way, the bearish candle should be 150% engulfed this green candle. That is where this is a valid pattern. So same rules goes for this. When this candle is formed in a support area, directly go for a buy as per rule number two. Rule number one is wait for, if it is forming in the downtrend, we can wait for our next candle confirmation and we can go for a buy. And if it is forming in the sideways, don't validate it. And same rules goes for here. If the candles formed in the uptrend, wait for a confirmation the next day of selling, and then we can go for a sell. If it is forming in the resistance, directly go for a sell or directly exit if you are an investor. Then don't validate this candle in sideways market. Rule number three. So far we have seen single candle pattern. This is a dual candle pattern. The last one is going to be triple candle pattern. So this is one of a very strong pattern which rarely occurs, but when this occur, obviously this will give you enough amount of profits. So let me explain this. The stock started falling, let's say 200 rupees, and it came all the way down to 150. This candle can be a pure bearish candle, and then here we can have a doji or a spinning top or a hammer. Anything can be there, but most probably we can see for a spinning top. If it is really going to form a bullish morning star, there will be a doji or a spinning top. And then this candle, the third candle, validation point for this pattern is this green candle should be minimum 60% pierced this candle. That is where this pattern is valid. Then it is called Morningstar. Morningstar always, what will do? It will rise. So the price of the stock will rise from this place. And same thing in the uptrend, such a beautiful bullish candle followed by a spinning top or a doji can come into picture. As I have already mentioned, spinning tops and doji, long leg doji, doesn't matter if it is in red or green, as it is an indecisive candle. So this is going to be, and then it should be minimum 60% of this green candle. It can be more than 100% or 150%, doesn't matter, but minimum qualification for validating this pattern is 60%. It should be at least till here. That is where we call this pattern as a bearish evening star. So I believe day before yesterday, this pattern formed in Nifty. I posted in my channel. I believe Clifford would have seen that. And what happened to Nifty, if you go to 2 days previous, 2 days back chart, you should be finding at least 200 points fall. Whenever this pattern, morning star and evening star forms, definitely it will definitely give profits. It will not leave you an empty hand. That is what I can confidently say. So same rules goes for this pattern. So rule number one, if it is forming in the downtrend, this pattern, you can wait for a confirmation and you can go for a buy. If it is forming in the support area, obviously you can go for a buy. If it is forming in the sideways, no need to validate. And same rules for this. If it is forming in the uptrend, we should wait for a confirmation, that is next day of selling, and we can go for a sell or take an exit if it is forming in the monthly candles. Rule two, it should form in this. If it is forming in the resistance area, obviously we can take a sell. Or if you are in an investor, obviously you can take an exit. So rule number three, don't validate these candles in sideways market. These are the six patterns so far I have explained. These are very, very robust patterns. I can show you in the live chart. I'll take you through the Nifty chart. We can go through some 30 years of data, and I can show you these patterns. Only these patterns have occurred whenever there is a downfall or a rise. I'll just share you. So here we go. I have already marked so that we don't have any confusion. So the data which we are seeing here is from 1990. Here we can see that the data is from 1990. So the first pattern, there is a morning star and the bullish rally came in all the way. It gave a huge upside. Then it came down. Again, there is a bearish engulfing. The market started falling. Again, it raised and we got a bearish engulfing, which is more than 150%. You can clearly see this bearish candle has engulfed this green bullish candle. And again, the market has started falling. And again, we see a inverted hammer here. What happens when inverted hammer comes in? It will definitely rise. Same way, the market started rising. Here we see a bearish engulfing at the top. It is obviously the first time the market has hit almost 1,300 plus points. That is where bearish engulfing has come into picture. And obviously what has happened is there is a huge fall. There is a huge fall from 1,300 to 800 points. So almost some 500 points drop. Here we see a clear bullish engulfing, again, some 300, 400 points rally. Here we see a shooting star with a confirmation. Again, the rally started downside. The market went up. Again, there we can see a spinning top with a clear bearish engulfing. So what happened? The market started falling. Again, it went up, or we can call it as a small retracement. Again, same shooting star confirmation. Again, the market has fallen from 165 to 800 level, 797, almost some 350, 400 points. Again, we got a bullish morning star. What happens when a bullish morning star comes? Huge rally. We can see a huge rally. From if you take a buyer bought here or even here from 962 to 1772, almost 800 points rally. Again, what we see here is a clear bearish engulfing. What happened? Clear downfall. Again, small correction. Here we see a clear evening star. And what happened? The bearish rally continued. It came down, again it went up. There is an evening star. Again, market started falling. Again, it went up. Again, what happened? We can see a clear bullish engulfing. When the bullish engulfing happened, it is a support area. Obviously, we could have gone for a buy here. From 1010, we reached till almost 2014. So 1,000 points profit. So again, what happened? From 1,900 levels, 2,000 levels, there was a drop till 1,450. So 500 points drop after this doji. We can call it a spinning. Here it is a spinning top. Here it is a doji. Here is a spinning top. Obviously, it is a bearish spinning top. Then 500 point drop. Again, what has happened? It has given a clear bullish spinning top with a confirmation. And see the rally here. The rally started from, as per the rule, we should have taken the trade here, 1,646. And the rally is something amazing. From 1,648 to this level, 5,000 level. There has been no correction. There was just retracements every time, small retracements, but 1,600 to 5,000 points, such a big rally. So I believe everybody would have not forgotten this 2008 crash, Lehman Brothers collapse. Nobody would have forgotten this. Even before it happened in the mid of 2008, but the market has shown a clear indication with the help of a bearish engulfing. See, here is a bullish, we call it as a bullish Marbozo, but I have not thought that. But it is let's consider this as a small bullish candle and followed by such a big bearish candle. It is purely bearish engulfing. And what happened? From 6,000 to this candle low is 2,252. In such a big collapse, market crash also, we could have identified the crash with just with this pattern. And obviously this is going to be the first time the market has reached 6,000. So obviously this is a first time high, and it is called as a resistance, we can call it as. And obviously we could have taken a sell here, 4,000 points we could have made. Sorry, 3,500 points. Again, what happened? There is a small consolidation for 5-6 months. It is a spinning top, then a clear bullish engulfing, and again this is a bearish candle. So we cannot consider this candle. So we have to just consider this candle alone. So that is why I haven't mentioned this as a Morningstar. I have mentioned this it as a bullish engulfing. So what happened from 2700 levels? Let's consider here. From here, 3050, market has gone to again 6,000 levels. Such a huge rally in just 2 years. So again, what happened? Here it is a spinning top and a confirmation. So what happened? From 5,800 to 4,500. So 1,300 points rally, downside rally. So again, we got a bullish engulfing. What happened? Market has raised from this place. Let's say even if I have taken trade here, the stop loss has not hit. The stop loss is here. The stop loss has not hit. So from 5,190 to 9,083. Such a big rally. So again, what we got is, this is the evening star. Evening star, and if you'd have taken a sell here or exited here, that will be safe. If you'd have taken a trade at 8,466, here we got 6,950. So almost 1,500 points, easy 1,500 points. And here we got a bullish engulfing. So again, from 7,700 to 8,813, some 1,000 points. Again, we got a bearish engulfing from here. 8,700 levels to, we got a drop till 7,890. So almost some 800 points. Again, what has happened? A morning star. This is a sideways market. This is not a sideways market. It is a corrective market. This is a higher low. It has formed in the higher low. So we should have wait till here, so that the previous high has broken, and we, if we'd have taken trade here at 9,000 level, we went to 11,760. So again, what happened? A bearish engulfing, market corrected to 10,000 level. From 11,760 to 10,004 was the low. So 1,600 points profit. Again, there was a rise. Here it is a hammer. Market started moving upside. So again, it went up. We got a clear spinning top, and again, market crashed. It is not a crash, it is a fall. From 11,985 to 10,580. So almost some 1,300 points drop. Again, what happened? It is a spinning top, and it rallied from 11,400 to 12,293 was the high. So I believe nobody will forget this, such a huge crash in advanced state. In a good economy, got crashed 5,000 point crash. I gave the level of 12,000. I gave it to my Telegram channel and my WhatsApp group. So I posted the level on February 1st, 2020. The market started crashing on the very next week, and it gave almost 5,000 points in just 1 month. You no need to do some rocket science here. It is just very small pattern. If it is a monthly candle, if it is forming in the monthly candle with this kind of pattern, it is a clear doji. And this here comes a small it is a clear indication. So obviously what will happen? Market will start falling. That is what has happened. Again, the market went up. Here we have a hammer, such a bullish hammer. And what has happened? From 9,500 levels, I'm not taking 7,500 because nobody know whether market is going to rise or it is going to continuously fall. But the next month, in this month, we got a hammer. we got a hammer and confirmation, and now we can see such a good market here. We are very close to 13,000. So this is how I have shown 30 years of data. I have marked all the falls, all the rise, all the trend reversals I have shown, except the six patterns which I have explained has occurred every single time. Apart from the six patterns which I have explained, none of the patterns has occurred in the last 30 years. It doesn't matter if it is going to be a stock or a commodity or a cryptocurrency or a index, whatever it may be. These patterns will work in every single stock. I'll show you one more script, which is going to be very favorite, one of my favorite. It is a crude oil. We have data from in TradingView. We have data for only from 84. We are in investing.com. We have data from 1970. This is the data from 1983. So we have data for some 37 years. So market started here. Crude oil started trading here, let's assume. And what has happened? It is a spinning top. What happened? Clear fall. Again, what has happened? A spinning top. It went up. Again, a doji and a confirmation. Market started falling. Very good fall from 30 to 24, $6. $6 is almost 30% in that time. It is a good fall. And again, a good bullish hammer. The market went all the way up. And we have a shooting star. And after the shooting star, what has happened? You can see this. It is a very clear fall. And this is a bullish engulfing. This is a bullish engulfing and obviously a good rally. From this level, we can say it's from $13 to $22. $22 in 1987 is a huge money, I believe. And what has happened? It is a hanging man. What has happened? A clear fall from $22 to $12, almost 50%. Again, we have a bullish morning star. So all the way it went up. From $14 to 23.92, the high. So again, we got a spinning top, again a fall. Again, we got a clear morning star. From here, that is $20 to $40. Huge rise. So here we got a hanging man. Hanging man, when a man hangs, what happened? What will happen? He will die. Obviously, what will happen to the stock? The stock price will come down. So that is what happened here. From $34, it came to 17, 50% drop. Again, a doji or a spinning top, we can say, bullish spinning top. From 19 to 25, some good rise. So after this bullish bearish engulfing, it came down. Again, there is a doji plus confirmation from 19 to $23, 23.95. Again, there is a shooting star. From $22, it came all the way down to $13, 50% drop. Spinning top, good rally. From $14, we can see $26, close to 80%. And after that, we got a clear shooting star, but still next month it has gone up, but it didn't hit the stop loss. If you measured the Wick measurement stop loss technique, if you followed that technique, the stop loss didn't hit. Here itself, the market gave a clear indication the market has started will be falling, and same happened.
Mr. Nagarajan, I think there's some questions. Maybe I don't know if you want to take, because
yeah, these are
relating to the concept. I think
sure. We can go ahead, please.
I think somebody is asking, what is the difference between a bullish engulfing and a morning star?
Bullish engulfing is a two candle pattern and a morning star is a three candle pattern. Bullish engulfing comes into picture when there is a red bearish candle followed by a green candle, which should be engulfed 150% more than the previous bearish candle. That is where a bullish engulfing comes into picture. evening star or a morning star is a triple candle pattern. If you here we can see, I'll expand it and show you. Yeah, here we can see a evening star. Here we can see a evening star. This is the resistance area, because we can see such a good resistance and a good evening star. The market started coming from here all the way from $26, and it came till $21. Again, what happened? There is an evening star. When evening star comes, obviously the price will drop. That is what has happened. Am I audible, or did I answer your question?
I would like Mani sir to do that. But other common question that I'm seeing from at least four participants is about the periodicity of the trend. Is it only for a long term trend that you're looking, or is it even daily, hourly?
Even 1 minute candle works in this pattern with these rules. It satisfies for an intraday trader to investor. Let it be anyone or any time frame. It works like a magic in all time frames. I have shown in monthly candles because I want to show you past 30 years data. If I go with 1 day or 1 minute candle, it will take hours to explain this. That is why I have taken monthly candles, so that the explanation will be short and sweet.
Okay. Thank
you. Yeah. Now, just a minute, Akhil. You know, if you see that evening star, what you've shown now, mm-hmm. correct?
Yeah.
So the red candle is bigger than the green, correct? Red one, correct?
Yes, this red is bigger than the green.
So that means it is not bearish engulf. Why it is not bearish engulf?
It is not bearish engulfing. In the middle, we have a doji.
Okay.
That is why it is called evening star. The basic difference between bullish engulfing, bearish engulfing, and the evening star, morning star is engulfing pattern is a two candle pattern, and morning star and evening star is a triple candle pattern.
Okay.
And the validation point is in evening star, it should be pierced 60% of this green candle. Yeah. Or if it is a morning star, it should be 60% than the red candle.
Okay.
Yeah. And again, after such a good fall, we got a spinning top. And again, a good rally. So again, we got an evening star. A bullish candle, spinning top, followed by such a big bearish candle. And
Hi, good evening. I have a question. Generally, what happens is what we are seeing here is a postmortem analysis of what happened. Now, generally, while the trends
course, yes.
are on live scenario, you mm-hmm. cannot foresee or look forward and justify or take a hunch as to how it's going to pan out. So even these, whether it is daily, minute, hour, day, week, or month, or year, as we take it, in any of the scenarios, these analysis can be done post-mortem. While the trading session is on, at that point of time, how do you take a call? Because that's where you either make money or you lose money. This session is informative and educative. Pardon my question, is just that I can understand this as a postmortem. After the session has closed today evening, I can analyze how the market has panned out, so I can plan for tomorrow. But while today's session is on, if I have open positions, either long or short, how do I take care of them? That's the more important thing. So how do we take calls on them? Because what happens is, as you go by the day or the minute chart or the hour chart, patterns are reversing quite more frequently than by the daily or the weekly or the monthly.
Mm-hmm. Of course, yes. Okay. Answer to your question is very simple. You're asking a very common man question. So that is what in the middle of the session, I told every time before starting the candles or sticks, I told I have been sharing the charts in the live market. Whenever these patterns are forming, I have given the calls. Every single day, I'm giving a call in either a Nifty or a Bank Nifty, or let it be any stock, whichever comes into my radar, I have given the stock, given the pattern, I have shared the charts. That is because of practice. When just a single day knowing these candles and reading the rules will not work. Obviously, as you said, it is going to be a postmortem analysis, but it helps. It helps really, because if you are an investor and if there is a strong pattern as per our rules in a monthly candle, definitely it will help you to come out of your loss, or at least it can, it will help you to minimize the loss. Making everybody will not be a day trader. 90% of the people will be into investment. I'm talking about the audience who are present here. I know many who are in intraday, more than investors, but because in if you compare the last 6 months data during the COVID period, 50 lakh accounts, trading accounts has been opened in Indian market. So I don't know how many are in good in technicals, how many has lost the money. Without knowing these stuffs, without following some good rules, they will definitely lose the money. As you said, in the live market, catching these patterns is really tough. But if you start practicing these candlesticks with the rules, definitely you can identify what is the next candle it is going to form. And there are retracement levels that I'm going to teach in the next session, the coming session about Fibonacci. That there you will come to know what will be the next candle. So what can be the decision made on the what can be the decision made at that point of time, whether you can go for a sell or you can go for a buy. Levels are very, very important. If it is going to be a reversal level, or it going to be a corrective level, or it is going to be a breakout level, we can definitely know with the help of Fibonacci. Did I answer to your question?
Thank you very much. Thanks.
Yeah.
Hello. Hello, Mr. Nagaraj.
Yeah.
One small layman doubt. This charts and the pattern which is really nice. Do you have any readily available, like will you be able to substantiate the same on a script, like any script, whichever your choice, you can pick it and show it to us, like this script has moved like this, so this is how it has happened.
Yes, please. Which stock you want to analyze? I'll analyze just before.
Anything of your choice, just to...
No. Choice is yours. I give it to your choice.
Okay, then Reliance will take it. Reliance Industries.
Definitely, yeah. Same way I'm coming from 1995. So here we got a bullish engulfing and it went up. And again, a piercing pattern. Again, it has reversed. I believe it should be 0.618. If you measure the Fibonacci, it should be 0.618. I'll show you. I'll tell you. Yeah. I'll tell you what is Fibonacci. And okay, this has more than 0.618. Okay, again, we have got a bullish engulfing. After a good fall, this is not a support area. So we have to wait for the next candle. So we have to take a trade here. If you have taken trade here at 25, in a couple of months, it went up to 74.5. And the next candle followed by this is a bearish engulfing. Obviously, what has happened? If it have taken a sell, this should be your stop loss. The stop loss didn't hit. It came all the way down till 19 from 29. Here also, there is a bearish engulfing. There was a retracement. Here is a clear bearish engulfing. If you'd have taken a trade here, keeping this as a stop loss from 32 to 19, good profits. We got a bullish engulfing. Sorry, we got a clear morning star. It is a bearish candle followed by a, let me enlarge it. It is a, we can call it as an inverted hammer. So then we got a bullish candle. Collectively, these three candles are going to be Morningstar. After a Morningstar, what has happened? From 22, we can say, let us not go here. Let us go till here. This is it. From 22 to 58, more than 100%. The next time, we got a spinning top. Spinning top. At the first time, when we reached 100 rupees, here we got a spinning top and it came all the way down. Rule number two, if it is formed in the resistance place, go for a sell. If you would have shorted here at 97, this is 50% profit. Again, we got a bullish spinning top, bullish engulfing from 71 to 85 is the high price. Again, we got a continuous dojis spinning. It is a bearish spinning top followed by a fall. bearish candle confirmation. So from 68, where is the candle? 68, it fall to 55. Okay, let us go to current trend, current market. We are seeing the old days. Right now, what has happened? As I told in while discussing about bearish engulfing, this is not a proper bearish engulfing because I'll tell you the reason. This is a bearish engulfing, but to a common man. But for me, I won't say this is a bearish engulfing because this month, that is the in the month of September, the market, the Reliance has opened at 2,100 and closed at 2,234. And the next month, it has opened at 2,263. So from 2,234 to 263, there are buyers. So if the candle started from here, that is 2,234.5 at the same place, and it has fallen and given 100%, 150% fall means I would have gone for a sell. But for me, it is not a bearish engulfing. The stock can again take a rally and it can go up.
Thank you. One small, this one, because since I got your here, I could able to finally connect with you what you're explaining. Only okay. One doubt. This Reliance one, if you go back at a place, there is a substantial drop has come there. Can you go back a little bit, which you even go back? Go back, come to 97, the place where you can see these drops. Yes.
Okay.
This place. Okay. In this place, like for example, there is no indicator here, right? See, the stock has been continuously on upward trend and suddenly it gave a significant drop, although it started here.
Mm-hmm.
The two big, the big, these ones, the columns, green and then the red ones here.
Okay. Yeah, I can see that. Yeah.
So here, yeah, without any indicator, like for example, if I'm holding my stock and the next, mm-hmm, next see, I could see that it is a continuous fall, like as you said, but without any indicator. So how would we feel like here, because there is no time also to give an indication in this case. I don't know, mm-hmm, whether I'm reading right or I'm like,
definitely. Yeah. Yeah. You're reading right. Yeah. I don't depend on indicators, but pure price action candles will tell us what or where the stock is going to head towards.
Okay.
So after this candle, it is a clear bearish engulfing. After this bearish engulfing, it has respected a trend line. Trend line is a support. It is a vertical support. It is a diagonal support. It has respected it has respected the trend line and it has given an inverted hammer. Inverted hammer is a bullish symbol. Obviously, then the next month also, it has given a confirmation and what has happened is a clear buy.
Okay.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. If you look for indicator. Yes, please.
Yeah. See, now, so keeping in line with Reliance Industries' performance, mm-hmm, the RIL shares have taken a hit. It has breached 1900. So from here on, what is the expectation? I mean, will it be further down or it might improve?
Okay.
I don't think you should make predictions on this this thing on a specific stock. I wouldn't advise that.
Yeah, we can keep it for the last part, I believe. I'll come back to Reliance again.
Because I think you need to cover the Fibonacci, I think, because some of the
sure.
Specific stock trends, you need to understand that concept for you to explain, I guess, analyze. Yeah.
Sure. Answer to the question is here itself. I'll give a simple example. It has touched the target and it is trying to come down. It can come till 1600. It is the retracement level. After that, it can get a bounce. Fine. Because every single thing will happen or react as per the Fibonacci.
You'll have to explain them Fibonacci, then only they'll understand.
Okay. Yeah. I believe we can go back to Fibonacci then.
Okay.